Prepare for chapel and make it double.
Ugh. Don't you ever say that again in your life.
Does your dad have the perfect name for that? Look.
James.
No.
Yahoo! Waha Buffet.
Oh, wait. Prepare for trouble. And make it double. Hell no. It ain't that ugly for that shit. You petty.
Okay. What piece did you get?
Pizza downstairs.
I mean, what kind of pizza is it?
Okay.
Alright, so this is no song about. Get closer.
No, I'll sit right here.
Okay. Well.
Put the headset on that man.
Alright, this is gonna be an interview, okay? Yes.
I've only got 5 minutes.
No, you have 50 minutes.
Oh, no, you got 50 minutes.
Ask away, guys. Well,
okay. Have you heard of this show called Dragon Ball Z?
I heard it. I've seen it rolling around, but I haven't seen it.
I think you should watch it. It's a pretty good watch. All right. Next question.
Do you put sugar in your Kool-Aid?
I don't drink Kool-Aid.
Understandable.
Well, okay, go.
Do you season it on your meat?
What?
Do you use seasoning on your meat?
Yeah, like what kind of seasoning do you use?
Seasoning?
Yeah,
Does ketchup count?
Sure.
I mean, like a grilled seasoning, like stuff like that.
Salt, pepper, lemon pepper, seasoned salt. Do you use that kind of stuff?
No.
All right.
Keep asking.
Yeah, Cedric, you got any questions?
Are you a Trump supporter?
Yes.
All right. What is it about Donald Trump that appealed to you? That made you want to go in there and vote for him?
He don't BS around.
That's true.
That's true. That's real. Give him that.
Sasha, go.
All right. Raggio, you go.
And he's not a criminal.
Whoa.
Go. What else?
We're still talking about Donald Trump, so go ahead, Raph.
What do you think is the least appealing thing about Donald Trump?
The least appealing thing.
The least appealing thing?
Yeah.
Yep.
I'm gonna go with the answer y'all want to hear, probably his hair.
Give it all.
Chat, it's fine. Answer the way you like.
Yeah.
Man, we're not part of the hardcore left, man.
All about honesty. We're just all about honesty. Wait, what?
Go.
Oh, snap. Gotta put me on the spot like that, man. Alright, hold up. I'm thinking of a question. Oh, yeah. How do you think we might need, like, more diversity in, like, our presidential, like, whenever we elect a president, do you think there should be like an Asian president, a Hispanic president, another black president? What's your stance on that?
If there's a good person, yeah.
All right.
That's
what's up.
Cedric, go.
How do you feel about staying your ground law?
What?
Florida.
My ground ball or round ball?
Stand your ground law in Florida.
What does that even mean?
It means
you can shoot someone if they think you're attacking you.
Yeah, it's where you should.
But you shoot someone that they're attacking you.
If I felt in danger of my life, yes.
Okay. Keep going.
What's your ideal vacation spot?
Of water and sand.
Nice.
That's not a place.
Way anymore, that is.
Well, my room had water and sand in it.
Your room's not my vacation spot.
I've heard other stories. About, anyway. Next question, Raph.
Did you grow, what cartoons did you grow up as a kid? Or did you
what cartoons up? Have you watched?
All of them.
No, what kind? Yeah, what kind of cartoons did you like grow up on when you were younger?
Tom and Jerry, Pink Panther.
Ah, the classics, the classics.
Nice.
Woody Woodpecker.
All right. Next question is: do you think Jesus is white or black?
Well, based on everything that's been presented, I have to go with white.
Okay.
Wait, but why?
Yeah,
why?
I mean, all the documentary pictures, literature, all that stuff depicts white, but that's just what has been presented.
That is true. That is what has been presented. That is true. But if you look deep into where he was from, he might actually be Middle Eastern.
Yeah.
That's possible because it is. Foreign country, Jerusalem, Israel.
Now, personally, that wouldn't change my opinion of Jesus at all. It's just more historically accurate.
You say that doesn't change any because it's historically accurate.
Okay.
All right, Cedric, go. Well, someone.
Yeah, Raph.
You can go. I gotta think of a question.
Will go.
What's your stance on gay rights?
Well, when you go back to the previous question, you go back to Jesus and it's wrong.
All right.
But. People have the choice of what they want to do, so that's how they want to float, and that's how they float.
Alright, nice.
I'll still go.
If I had a friend that was gay, it don't change the friendship. I've had both of them. So. All right.
What if one of your kids was gay?
Alright, Rob.
Wait, no, Will was still asking a question.
Oh,
I just said like, what if someone in your family was gay, like, I don't know, like your like your cousin, your son, your daughter, or whatever.
I mean, just because I don't believe what they do does not mean I'll still be a don't change the relationship.
Alright, cool.
Next question.
Alright, where do you work at and do you like your job?
Where do you work? Where do you do?
IT computer consultant.
Mm-hmm. What's that?
System administrator.
What's that?
Information technology.
Does that answer your question?
Yes, it does.
Mm-hmm.
Do your work?
Where?
Do you enjoy your work?
Oh yeah. Nice.
Cedric?
You probably have to get me. Will, you can go ahead.
Come on, Cedric, I ain't got no questions, man. Ask something.
I'm not taking a picture. Oh, okay.
So, how do you feel about Hitler?
Cedric, you across the street, you need to answer, ask that question a little bit louder, man. Cedric, you are across the street, you need to ask that question a little bit louder, man.
Oh, okay. So, how do you feel about Hitler?
Only thing I know is just a little bit about history, and that's all. So, I don't have enough knowledge to make an answer.
Next question.
Are you pro-life or pro-choice? Like, what would you consider yourself to be?
That's a words and stuff.
I'm against abortion, whatever which one that is.
Okay.
Is that pro-life, right?
Yes.
Okay.
Okay.
Off well.
Favorite subject when you were back in school, or least hated?
Wait, what'd you say, Rev?
What?
Favorite subject or least hated, if you hated school?
What was your favorite thing in school?
P.E.
Why?
Because it's fun.
With my big green
sports, and some people don't like to learn.
You play dodgeball?
Hey, you know they got rid of dodgeball recently. How you feel about that? They said it hurts kids, so they got rid of dodgeball in schools nowadays.
Oh, I got another question after that.
Get closer to your thing, Rafael.
Sorry.
He's not deported, so we can't do it. He's under right now.
Bro, cause y'all boys like miles away from y'all mics, man. Cedric,
pull up, Ralph.
All right,
Cedric, it is your turn.
All right. Let me think. How do you feel about Bush?
Which one?
The sun.
Both of them.
What?
The sun.
Yeah, the sun.
I wasn't really into politics back then.
Oh, true.
But I didn't keep up with it. But I'm sure he's like any other one, done some good and done some bad.
Yep.
Alright, next question.
Alright, how do you feel about SJW culture?
He don't know what that is, man.
Rap, stop. Get out, Rap.
He's not that deep in the internet, man.
Rap, get out. Bye.
SJW culture doesn't extend to the internet. It extends to the...
Rap, get out.
It started on Tumblr, dog.
Rap, get out, you Twitter. Twitter bait, get out.
It isn't even a Twitter thing, it's a thing in general, like, not just internet things.
Try another question.
And we say, but it has its origins in the internet, though.
Alright, how do you feel Obama did at his job? Honestly.
Alright, we feel about what?
Obama.
Obama did his job.
How he did his job?
Yeah.
On a scale from 1 to 10?
Yeah. Sure.
With the 10 being perfect?
Three.
Dang, alright.
Why?
What makes you say so?
Why Why so low?
Yeah.
Well, he sent money to the terrorist. He freed the terrorist. Got the terrorist out of jail.
All right.
What else?
There's a
penalty for people that don't have insurance. Now I got to pay for insurance. Pay a fee to have insurance.
To be fair.
Past
presidents have supplied the Taliban with actual funds and ammunition and stuff. So I'm not gonna say Obama's the only one at fault when doing that stuff.
No, but he done it secretly.
Yeah, so have most presidents. They just don't like show it out in the open. You know, Trump got exposed not too long ago.
Yeah.
He was in cahoots with the Russians.
Right, and Trump is a clown.
Nah, maybe it's back up here a second. Has that been proven, or is that just?
Oh, it's
because Obama's been proven secretly done it.
Yes, Trump been talking to the Russian president, and the Russian people got Trump elected by hacking the computer during the election. It's been proven on news numerous times.
On fake news?
On real news. Global News, CNN, Fox, NBC.
Fake news.
Morning time news. Late night news.
This boy,
every day.
Cedric says Stephen Colbert.
Right.
All right. Next question. All
right. You want to ask the question?
Yeah.
You can get close to your microphone.
True.
Was Donald Trump your first choice for the Republican nominee or president in general?
Was he your first choice for anyone in the election? Or was there
not
someone?
Not for this one.
No, I didn't know, man. I really liked it before that.
You had Ben Carson
and Ted Cruz.
You know, those Zodiac killer.
I mean, in general, I'm going to say the Democratic stuff too, but like,
don't rap. No, stop rap.
I mean, dude, like, it doesn't matter, man. Like,
yeah.
Even if you're fully like Democratic or Republican, like,
I mean,
gotta be honest.
I mean, to be honest, the only good Democratic one was Bernie Sanders.
Right.
Hey guys, go.
And he got cheated out of it.
Exactly. It's a shame.
Trump used that Russian.
Rest in peace, Martin O'Malley.
Trump didn't put Bernie out. Hillary did.
Exactly.
Got cheated by Hillary Clinton.
It's like Ms. Real out here in these political parties.
Let me ask you a question.
All right.
Sure.
Knowing that Hillary had U.S. prisoners killed, would you still support her?
We don't support Hillary.
Yeah, that's the thing. We don't support her.
Poor
that's
Hillary.
Because,
no. No, I don't.
That kid.
I don't support Hillary Clinton.
Every politician has some skeletons in their closet.
Yeah.
I personally thought this, like, this election was, like, the worst. Wait, the best of the two evils.
Okay, describe it. What makes them each one of them evil?
All right. Well, okay. Starting with Trump. All right. The evil that he done. Trump is basically a clown. He is dumb, stupid. He got into bankruptcy like so many times with different companies. He gonna run America like his company, and then when he get tired of it, he's just gonna go get bankruptcy and leave. And that's what he's basically doing. Then he don't know how to talk to people. Like, with Australia, he gonna talk to the prime minister and hang up the phone. On the prime minister, hang up the phone on him. That you messing up relationship with different countries that we need, because without those countries, you don't know if another country is going to start an attack on your country. Australia is used for spy, intelligence, everything, and Trump don't know how to talk to people. And it goes back to talking with the enemy, Russia, Korea, North Korea. He's making deals with Russia, and that's a bad thing.
Okay, Korea and North Korea was the problems even with Obama.
Yeah, that's true.
Yeah. I'll say this, though. Hillary represented everything that was wrong with our government, and Trump represented everything that's wrong with, like, American society. That's why it was pretty difficult for most people to pick between the two of them during election time.
Yeah, and you gotta remember what Bill Clinton's done.
Yeah. Bill Clinton's a whole different subject. I don't see Bill Clinton when I'm talking about Hillary. I just talk about Hillary. Because they both got some dirty deeds done cheap. Under the table. If you catch my Tokyo drift.
But when it comes to who's evil than the other person, I have to say Trump.
Well, they're both evil. But they're politicians.
Yeah, when but you got the lesser evil.
He's not a politician like everybody else has been. He's never been in the government.
He is now.
And that's what scares me.
Politician.
And that's what scares me. He don't know anything about the affairs of different countries around the world. At least with Hillary, she knew who was enemy, who was friend, who was neutral, and the trading system with different countries and how you act. He don't. And that's what scares me the most.
Hey, I gotta be honest here. I'm like the devil. I'm playing devil's advocate here. Trump knows business. You gotta give him that.
That is true.
Some of the political stuff is business. You gotta know how to work a deal.
You're right on that.
How many people do you know that became a billionaire twice?
These are facts. Oh, but how do you feel about the Muslim ban?
Wait, no, answer the question.
Answer the question, Will.
What you mean?
How many people you know has become a billionaire twice?
Oh, that's true, that's true. Can't name a whole lot of people. But, you know, I'm not denying Trump's,
I'm not trying to change your mind or anything. I'm just talking.
Oh, no, I'm not denying Trump's a business chops. I'm not denying that. When it comes to business, this man is a genius. I just don't think he should be in control of something as large as a whole country. That's all I'm saying. I think he needs experience under his belt to tackle this kind of thing. Now, while it is true that most things dealing with politics is also dealing with business, but it's also stuff in politics that's just under the umbrella of politics. And that's where you fall short.
Yeah, well, he may not be perfect in the political side of it, but he's not giving the dog and pony show like everybody else and just telling you crap. He's actually telling you what he thinks. Yep. You don't have to figure it out.
And I'm scared of he's making the wrong business deals. Now, okay, his whole campaign was set by saying things about immigrants, then saying that he's gonna bring jobs right back to America to make America great again. But his company are in China making ties and suits, and he got companies in I'm pretty sure in India and around the whole world, he got companies. So that's jobs that could have been over here in America from the get-go.
Okay. Do you have Nike shoes on that
one? Yeah, I got some Nike.
No, Cedric,
you know where they come from?
Cedric, where FUBU?
China.
it comes from China because...
Okay.
Damn, Cedric Hushmo.
Where did your Kobe's come from?
No, he's a wise bike.
That's a joke.
No, I'm just going to, I mean, we're going with the popular stuff that people buy. That's it.
He put you on hush mode, Cedric.
I don't really even buy the popular stuff, but that still go against the dang what he's saying. He said he's going to bring jobs back to America, and people are always taking our jobs. Immigrants are taking our jobs, and people around the world are taking our jobs. But you placing your companies around the world, and your company could have been here in America from the get-go.
What kind of business is he in?
Hmm?
What kind of business does he run?
He got different kind of business. He runs a hotel business in New York, but he branched off and made suits and ties, and he had his own colleges that went bankrupt in early 2000, and he had, and like I said before, suits and ties, and he put it over in different countries. So that go against what you were saying on your campaign trail, saying that all these people are taking our jobs, but you're the one who put it over there, and you could have put jobs back in America from the get-go when you were thinking of the idea of having companies around the world.
Hang on, he's thinking about it.
There's a small portion of that is correct. But when you run a hotel business, I mean, Holiday Inns all across the world.
Yeah.
Hilton's all across the world.
They need to go down too. They need to bring, if they supporting Trump, they need to say, hey, we should have put our jobs here first before branching out to different countries. That way that people over in America had jobs before those people in different countries take our jobs.
That's why I think America's like taking the loss in, man, because we're too busy trying to branch off into other countries when instead we should be focusing more of our energy and time on fixing what's been broken here before we do.
Okay. Hey, Detroit, Michigan. Exactly. What happened there?
Yeah, the GM plant went under. Therefore, and it was a major source of like the city's income. And so Detroit, and so when GM went under, the city itself went under.
And then went overseas.
Exactly.
And when did that happen? Who was president?
Awesome. Oh, dang. That was some decades ago. But financial business aside.
No, he got you there, Will.
If you know, hold on now. If you go look at the stock market, last two or three days, it's closed at a record high of all time. Jobs are coming back.
I'm not saying they're not.
There you are.
Now, if you want to talk about the immigrants, that's a different situation.
First of all, Tyler needs to stop instigating, man.
I have no problem with them coming over, the people coming over to the U.S., but you just have to do it legally.
Right. What about the jobs?
Well, if they come over here legally and they want to work at McDonald's, they want to build houses, whatever they want to do, fine. Those jobs are here now.
Well, to be
done, American people don't want to do those jobs.
That's true.
Then why are people complaining that they're taking the jobs and making it seem like it's such a big problem when they're taking, just like applying for the jobs nobody really wants?
Let's look at who the people are that's complaining. What jobs do they have?
They have like some cushy jobs, man.
Working in a business working in a whole damn whole tower in cubicles with the competitors and stuff, having suits on, working 9 to 5. Having those office chairs sitting down on it, but they had the nerve to complain about people washing their windows and cars and stuff. And then when those people asked for a better education or a better life, that's when they said, nope, you getting deported right back to your country.
don't think that.
Because they brought in people over here to do it cheap.
But that's still not fair. They should get, if they had to work their asses off and bust their asses for a long time, then the person who working in that cubicle 9 to 5, I think that they should get a better education, a better life, and especially those people who working in Trump Tower, those Hispanic, Latino people who working there, they should be the one getting a good life. And the people who taking care of Trump kids, and they're Hispanic, there's no doubt about that, they're Hispanic. They should get a better education and a better lifestyle when they ask for it, not getting deported back if they don't do their work.
Maybe if you're here illegally, they should give you an opportunity to go get your, like, get your stuff set up, so where you can be an actual legal citizen, and not just kick you out on site.
Yeah, I don't think it's a part of who or what they're doing. It's just a part that they're not legal.
Yeah. Well, and you gotta understand. Well, and like a lot of things people don't like to bring up is that America is founded on immigration. The only people that are really not immigrants in America are Native Americans and descendants of slaves. Because the Native Americans were inhabited this place first. And when Africans were brought over here, it was by force.
And they built the country from ground up.
Well, what about all these other countries? How would they had to be built up somehow? What was the first city?
I mean, it was Canaan, but we're not talking about all that. We're just talking about like how people in America see how are also against immigration, yet their like forefathers are immigrants themselves.
Right.
Donald Trump's wife is an immigrant.
Yeah.
True. But she's legal.
Yeah, that's true. I'm not saying illegal immigrants can just stay illegal and like do whatever. I'm not against registering to, you know, become like a legal citizen or anything like that. That's no problem to me. I just feel like we should be spending more time welcoming immigrants and helping them get their lives together instead of just being like divisive and wanting them to leave just because, you know, they're different. And I feel like that's what people are like mixing up. We live in the United States, but we act the farthest thing from it.
Right.
I mean, you're in Nashville, right?
Yes.
I mean, there are all kinds of people there.
Exactly. But most people don't embrace it.
Right. And I hate the phrase when they say that America is the land of the free, equal opportunity. No, if you're not, I'm sorry to say, if you're not white, you're out of luck. You know, you have those same
opportunities. time out.
Cedric, shut up, man. Time out.
Oh, snap. Cedric, gonna start it right.
That's just saying. I'm not trying to.
Let me give you these facts.
That's just race baiting, dude. Like,
so if you're not white, you're out of luck. But yeah, look at Major League Baseball. Look at NFL. Look at NBA. Look at the college team. Boys the race versus black versus white ratio.
But that's for like entertainment.
Yeah, that's entertainment. And plus, white people don't have to really try hard in that sport. Black people have to try hard in that sport. And like, for a white person in high school to be on the football team, it's easy for them. But you got a whole line of black people or different race trying to try out to be on the football team, and they got to try their hardest just to make a spot. But when a white person come on there and they throw a ball down the field, they give them a spot automatically.
Hey, come here. Come here. In the conversation too.
Where do you go to school at? King Ranch?
Yes, we all do.
Yeah.
You been to a basketball game?
Yeah.
No, he never goes outside.
This guy.
Only black people on the team. Three?
No, come here, Candy.
Oh, let me see.
Cedric, what are you saying? What are you saying?
I think what Cedric meant to say was, like, outside of the realm of, like, sports and entertainment,
okay,
we have to work twice as hard to achieve a certain kind of status that someone of another demographic might not have to work hard for.
It depends on what the area is, I would think.
True. I mean, coming from someplace like King Ridge, where like the black ratio to the white ratio, like the black to white ratio is really, really, really huge, because like that. 86% of students at King Ridge are black. So it's only natural that the football team, the basketball team, the cheerleading team is going to consist of mostly black people.
Okay, how do you apply that when there are only 26 NFL teams?
Exactly. Oh, no, I'm not trying to. I'm trying to, like, boost Cedric's point. So I feel like he missed some things on there.
He's helping you out right now.
No, I'm just talking. I'm not saying anybody's right or wrong. I'm just.
Oh, he's
in
a timeout, so.
Well, I mean, you got all the music industry in there.
Exactly, but that still falls under entertainment.
Okay.
Well, if we step out the realm of entertainment and look like at Job Force, and
I have an example. Hmm? Okay, I'm sure you're all aware of Colin Kaepernick, right? The dude who took the knee at the game during the Okay. Well, you see, before he started doing all that stuff that started causing all a bunch of controversy, he was just a regular football player throwing the ball around for people's entertainment. But the second he stopped trying to entertain people and wanted to speak on some actual issues that are going on, he got tons of backlash from it. Almost as if people were saying, like stop talking about these issues and go back to entertaining us for our enjoyment. It's like it's almost as if we don't really have much of a voice beyond our skills to entertain people.
This is just my opinion here. I don't think that was the. It has nothing. I mean, how to say this? The issue is not what he was protesting about. The issue was how he went about it.
Okay. How does one protest it then? Because we can't march in the streets and do like chants and stuff like that. No one likes it when we do that, and no one likes it when we take a knee at the game. So what is the right way to protest?
I mean, they've been protesting like crazy for a long time.
Exactly. Like the Boston Tea Party started off as a protest, as a way to make changes happen.
No. Well, here's the problem with the protest, though.
Okay.
You protest to make a point and speak your thoughts, but yet you don't protest to destroy people's property.
Well, no, that's rioting. Protesting and rioting are two different things.
Okay. But 9,000 out of 10, you see on the news or whatnot, what type of protest it is. It's rioting.
Exactly. But, like,
they can't
do it peacefully.
But the media always shows you their side of the story. They always show you, they want to show you the worst aspects of what we're protesting instead of like the more peaceful aspects. There's been more peaceful protests recently than there have been actual riots. They just don't show it to you.
So, I mean, it's like Kaepernick. Did you think that was right or wrong the way he went about it?
I think it was the right way how he went about it. He wasn't yelling. He wasn't screaming. He wasn't throwing things around. He put his knee on the ground to make a statement that he did not like how police brutality in this country was going about hunting down black people and basically killing us in the streets. He didn't like that. And I agree 100% with him. He didn't go hood. He didn't go ghetto. He put his knee underground respectfully and did his thing and showed that he wasn't with it. He showed that enough is enough.
Okay, let's go back to the rioting thing. You say they only show the bad parts on TV. Feel the same way about the police brutality? They only show the bad parts on TV?
I mean, that's true too. I mean, there's two sides to this story. I'm not saying I believe that all police officers just go around like beating up and shooting black people. There's good police officers out there too.
I'll be the first to tell you they're good and they're bad.
Yeah.
And they're probably more bad ones than good ones.
Yeah, I'm sure there are. And there's police officers out there, like good police officers, trying to make amends for the wrong things that other police officers have done. And that's good. Because police officers, I see like police officers nowadays going to neighborhoods and talking to kids and stuff. You know, actually helping the community. That's a good thing. There needs to be more of that. It's just a shame there isn't. I think that's what Colin Kaepernick, you know, is protesting. Not only just like the systematic racism that's happening in America, but the fact that there needs to be more good people to stand up for things that are just wrong in society.
I agree with that, but I have to go back to the way he done it during the national anthem.
Oh, and plus the national anthem and the Star Spangled Banner, it goes against black people, and it's racism in that speech.
Yeah, it's been edited over the years to where that stuff's been omitted.
What do you say, Will?
Oh, I was just going on what you're saying, because it's been edited and like stuff's been omitted over the years about it to make it more like socially acceptable.
Okay, let's go back to the police brutality.
Okay.
What's the reason you think there are so much of it? Because the police are so bad, or the suspects don't follow orders or obey commands, or think they just do whatever they want to do?
I think it's more of like a power thing when it comes to like police brutality. It's people that's growing up without anything, without any kind of control over anything. So as soon as they get that badge and gun, they feel like they hot stuff, you know.
They are some of those. Yeah, I agree.
Exactly. So I see, and there's also some like people that were like in like the Ku Klux Klan and stuff like that on the low. And now they have the badge and gun. It's pretty much open season for black people for them. There's police officers like that, and they've been caught with that stuff. But the officers that have done those like injustices haven't really been punished for their crimes, which they are. It's a crime, because if you remember Eric Garner, he was supposed to be selling like loose cigarettes. That's a misdemeanor. It didn't require taking his life to like get to bring him to justice or anything like that.
Oh, and another thing, when I said America is like the land of opportunity and equal rights for like not for black people or any other colored people, it goes back to this one case. It happened last year, the Stanford College case, where this white male raped a girl. But over here in Tennessee, in Vanderbilt, a black male and his friends raped the girl. But the white male got less years than the black male. He got only 1.5 years, and he got parole, the white dude from Stanford. And the black man got 15 years.
He hasn't went to court yet.
Yeah, and he got reduced sentence for testifying against the other one, right?
No, the one got to court yet.
Oh, okay.
It's been delayed.
No, Vanderbilt and that black man on the football team, they got tried yeah. like last year.
Yeah. Right, but the black boys has been delayed, I found.
No, they already got tried. They got like 15 years, and that dude from Stanford, he got paroled after 1 year in jail. So that's what I'm talking about. It's not equal, because they both did the same crime, and they should have got the same year. And they're just giving this man from Stanford a slap on the wrist because of his color of his skin. But any other race did the same thing, they would get more years or life in prison.
I thought it was only one of them raped her and the other one took pictures.
No, it was two people who raped her and the other one took a picture, and one boy was asleep in the room, and the one in Stanford, he raped the girl outside in the park. Will, you want to go on with opportunity and...
Okay, here we... Okay, I got the right phrasing. What do you think about political correctness?
Political correctness.
That's what I meant by SJW. Political correctness. That type of stuff.
Are you watching Tosh 2.0 again?
Oh. Down.
No, I'm just kidding. What was that? What you got?
Political correctness and stuff like that. What do you think of the whole...
You know what
he
said?
Give me an example.
Like all the genders and stuff. Like all the genders and stuff people come up with and stuff like that.
Yeah.
So like there's actually
like
people
when people get offended and stuff.
Like there's people who get mad if you refer to them as he or she. They just say stuff like, "Did you just assume my gender?" They say something like that. Like, there's really people out there that get, like, offended by, like, the smallest thing.
Unfortunately, that's what the world is today.
Yeah, true.
I mean, if you had a dog, somebody said your dog was ugly, you got offended. I mean, you'd be on TV.
Right.
Right, I agree.
So, another
the
question.
If it really matters, don't get the attention. This piggly crap is what gets on TV and gets all the attention.
Yeah. Well, you got another question?
Mm-hmm. Oh, I was just listening. Let me think. I'll skip me. I'll come back.
Alright, I got one. Do you feel that there are more black people on welfare or white people on welfare?
I think it depends on what part, what areas you're talking about. I will say it's it's hard to say now, guys. I'm gonna say it's probably more equal than what people think it is.
Raph, you got a question?
Nah, I don't. Ask for now.
Alright, no.
Good thing.
Oh, we need to pump the fire. Alright.
Let me ask you all a question.
Oh, yeah.
Go. Yeah, that's fun.
Far away.
I lost my question.
It's all good. I got a question though.
Okay.
How do you feel about video games?
I think it's like anything else that's good and bad.
Alright, true, true.
Like bacon's good for you, but eat it every day, all day long, then it's bad for you.
Yeah. Do you play video games from time to time?
Or how do you play video games before?
Yeah. I played video games before, but I don't now. Only games I play is what's on my phone.
Oh, true, true. Like the mobile games, that's what's up.
Yeah, more apps.
Yeah.
Okay, I got my question.
Okay.
And overall, including, if you include every area, subject, topic, or anything, do you feel that the white man, the black man is equally to the white? Or less or more?
Wait, say that again.
If you include all the topics,
all right,
all the subjects, all the areas,
all right,
do you think the white man and black man are equal? One of them more or less than the other?
I gotta say less than the other. Reason why. The black people, the system been against us from the beginning, since we got to this country. The system was made to be against us. We struggle day by day, waking up knowing that we're not gonna be nothing, that we're waiting for a miracle, waiting that someone can come down and save us from the nightmare that we had to go through during the 1600s, 1700s, 1800s, 1900s, and all the way up to the 60s. When Martin Luther King came to save us. The system today is still against black people. We get more jail time than a white person. We don't get the same education opportunity as a white person. We had to try twice as hard as a white person just to get the same job as a white man. The system always been against us.
Okay, let me.
That's powerful, Cedric.
Let me throw this out there. I tell you, I'm not racist whatsoever. I got friends that's black, and some of my best friends have been. I've been to every rap concert you can think of.
That's good.
But how can you say that the system is still against you when you look at the NBA, the NFL, all the sports, all the music industry?
Alright.
If you put all that, how can you say it's against you when those people are ruling those industries?
Because it's a form of entertainment. That's what they want. They want us to dribble the ball, make music, but when we try to make act conscious and tell them that we got our own mind and our own way of thinking, that's when they got a problem with it.
And look at who owns the teams and who owns the labels.
Yes. Oh, white people own the team. I'm not trying to be mean about them. Billionaires, millionaires, owning NBA team, NFL team, CEO of the team are white. And that's a part of entertainment. They have a problem. If we're not dribbling the ball making music, they got a problem with that. When we try to act like we got common sense, that's when they got a problem.
But you're so making a living smarter than that.
But that's the thing. We're still under someone else ruling.
But anyone can do what they do, though.
Yeah, we could do what they can do, but still. You gotta try.
It's just harder to get
hard. That's the whole thing.
Yeah, it's just harder to get there.
Okay. Yeah, it's harder to get there.
I'm trying to figure out the form of entertainment. I mean, those people played all through their childhood, college, high school, and then get drafted.
I'm not saying it doesn't take hard work to be like a
pop culture singer. That's what those people want to do.
Yeah, I'm not saying it doesn't like take hard work to be like a singer or like in the NBA or NFL or something like that. That stuff takes hard work. I'm not saying that. I'm just saying if that's the only areas we can dominate in, we can't do much else. It's just kind of limiting everything. You know?
But how many millions and billions of dollars are those people making doing that?
Exactly. Now, I'm not saying like they still go home broke after that stuff. That's obviously not the case. I'm just saying it's like the industries that those people are in are run by like older like white men. Because like they don't like put out albums, but they own the label that puts out the album. They don't dribble the ball and shoot the basket and make the touchdown, but they own the teams that do.
Jay-Z owns his label.
Exactly. That's one out of like very. That's one out of like maybe like 10 people, like 10 notable people of color that do though.
But all those people producing the music are blacks. Look at Michael Jordan.
That's true too, but he's come a long way from where he was when he started.
But how he started, he came from the bottom, and now he's here. He had to work hard, twice as hard, to be on the NBA team. Just and before that, in school, making those grades just to be on the basketball team and throughout college. He had to work twice as hard just to get there.
And Michael Jordan is like in his 50s. Michael Jordan is in his 50s, and he's at this status. He's in his 50s.
Yes.
Let me throw you this question. Do you think LeBron James will get $99 million a year for playing basketball?
I don't see why not.
Okay, anything else? I gotta wrap it up.
Alright, I got one more question.
Okay.
Do you believe that people make way too big a big deal about race and stuff? Minorities included. Because I'm honestly sick and tired of the race talk from both sides.
Then he left.
He got too excited, though, didn't he?
I guess. Dang, Raph, had one job.
He had one job, man. Good guy.
Do you guys have any last questions?
No, I think we covered everything we wanted to cover.
It's been nice talking to you.
Yeah, thank you for your time.